Hi students, this is the introductory video to your case study book, that is book number 2 that we all have launched for the case studies. Now this book that we all have launched covers 21 case studies from all the chapters that are there. All the theoretical case studies are covered up in this particular book. When I have tried to make video lectures of these, okay, for 21 case studies you have 21 videos. Approximately ranging around from 20 minutes to 40 minutes. That depends upon the size of the case study. Whenever I have done any lecture, okay, on the case studies, I have started with a recap that this case study is on what concept. I have tried to do a revision of that particular concept. Once that revision is done at that particular time, we start away with a case study. We discuss the case study. We try to read it. I try to read it with you, underline the important points and finish off the case study. Whatever case studies are there in your module, whatever case studies are there in your website, okay, of the institute, each and every case study is covered up in this particular book. Okay. After this, I'm trying to have one of the case studies which will get continued after my introduction is over. Make it a point that you watch that. I'll tell you also how our case studies to be answered. Apart from that, case studies will be coming as part of your paper in form of question number 1. It will be coming around for 20 marks. Do not ignore them, because first question is also a compulsory question. This is also the first book of case study that is getting launched in India. In Mumbai as well as across India, we'll be launching the book on 10th of Jan, which can be purchased through the links that I have given below. Either the links are there or they'll be coming on 10th of Jan, on the day that the book will be getting launched. Ensure that you take good advantage of it, because case studies in any case are here to remain, so therefore you should be knowing them. That's it. After this, the lecture will be starting. Let's start, guys. Now this is case study number 1. This is our first case study that we all are doing. This is on Porter's value chain analysis versus value shop. The last question of chapter number 1 that I had told you all, that what is value chain analysis and finally what is value shop. Basically, value chain analysis is there for manufacturing companies. Okay. Although in future a case study will be coming whereby you're going to be applying it to a retail sector also. Now the other thing, that was value shop. Now value shop was basically for those companies who are there in service sector and who are basically trying to solve some customized problems of the other companies. Okay, so let's start. This is slightly a big question, so pay attention please. Westwood Solar Solutions has mastered the art of developing solar domestic water heater that fulfills customers' needs. So therefore, these guys make domestic water heaters, geysers and all. WS designers and product developers focus on solutions to get rid of everyday hassles and transform these into a pleasant experience. Okay. So basically, like, you know, whatever problems you all have, say in domestic, okay, example, say in the morning you all want to take a bath, suppose there's a family of 10 people, so a small geyser might not be enough, okay, so therefore they take the account of all such kind of problems. WSS has also a wide servicing network that spans the length and breadth of India to ensure good care of the customers and products by providing prompt and present service experience. In the past, WSS has a dominant position in the Indian market. However, over the past 4 years, it has been found that its profits and its share in the market has gone down. Obviously, if it's a case study problem, there has to be some kind of issue that the company is facing right now. WSS has a business model comprising of the following steps. First, WSS highly qualified and skilled experts visit customers' location to identify and design the appropriate heater as per the customer's requirements. Okay. WSS experts are recognized as the best in the industry And the customers agree that they produce the most efficient solutions to their complaints. So this is a positive factor, like, you know, that these guys are recognized as one of the best in the industry, and they also have high qualified and skilled experts who visit the customers to find out whatever they all need. Okay, this is for second. At WSS in the laboratories, the heating design goes through intricate, complex and dynamic process. Prototypes are developed. Prototypes means kind of a demonstration model. How will the actual model look like? Are developed on the basis of discussions in the previous step. Okay. Therefore, these prototypes, thereafter these prototypes are tested. Once a final design is decided, such design is passed through the manufacturing division for the production. So this speaks about the manufacturing part. Okay, further. Third, then WSS manufactures the appropriate solar water heater to the desired specification and installs it at the customer's location. So this is your third step as such. Okay. So this is now the installation, and all happens at the customer's location. This is the installation process. Okay. Fourth, after the heater's installation, WSS renders annual maintenance services for which it is well known in the industry. So therefore, this is after sales service. Okay. Now, WSS customers pay a total price for the design, manufacture and initial installation of the solar water heaters, and an annual maintenance charge after that. Total prices are quoted before design and the work begins. Okay. So obviously, before the designing process will start, we will tell the customer that this will be the total quotation. Okay. Although customers appreciate high quality of the solutions provided by WSS team, however, they are complaining that overall prices are just too high. So customers agree to one thing, our quality is very good, okay, but the prices are too high. Customers have said that although other suppliers do not solve their problems as WSS does, they do charge less. They are saying even other guys, they might not do job as good as these guys, but still, okay, their prices are quite less. Consequently, WSS has to lower down the prices to compete in the market. There is a doubt that manufacturing and installation stages of the business model are not contributing sufficiently to the firm, since cost at both the stages are high. So this I am highlighting now. There is a doubt that manufacturing and installation stages of the business model are not contributing sufficiently to the firm, since the cost at both the stages is very high. So what these guys are thinking, that these two things, like, you know, this point over here as well as this point over here, manufacturing and installation is not happening in very cost efficient way. So they are not contributing much towards a profit. That is what these guys are saying. Let's continue. Partners at WSS have considered that this situation should no longer continue and have recommended that value chain analysis to be conducted as to identify the way forward for WSS. So these guys have thought that let's try to do value chain analysis. Okay, we all have done that. I will just try to do a recap after some time. Although majority of the shareholders are in agreement with the proposed value chain analysis, however, the senior partner W has stated that value chain analysis is an inappropriate idea. She says that she has heard number of criticisms of value chain model. Assuming yourself to be a management accountant of WSS, answer the following questions. First, discuss the benefit that may accrue to WSS from conducting a value chain analysis. Okay. Discuss the criticisms of Porter's value chain model in context of WSS. Explain other form of value chain analysis that might be more suitable for WSS. Okay. Now see. Let's start. Now, first of all, whatever you all have done in value chain analysis, Porter's value chain analysis. Now, it actually works in two steps. Okay, first, identify primary activities, identify secondary activities. We know primary, we know secondary. Primary, there are five activities: inbound logistics, then you have processing, that is manufacturing. Third is outbound logistics, whereby the finished goods is now going towards the suppliers, towards the distributors. Then you have marketing and sales. And lastly, you have after sales service. Now, when I was doing this particular thing as theory also, we say five steps. Inbound logistics, raw material is coming in. Then manufacturing happens. Outbound logistics. Then in that case, marketing and sales. Okay. And then in that case, after sales service. And then you have your secondary activities also. That is the infrastructure. That is the human resource. That is the technology. That is a procurement. That's okay. Now see, this is the last one, after sales service. Now, this kind of a structure now basically helps us to find out that let's try to categorize entire company into these five heads. And then in every head now, we try to find out which activities are contributing towards a profit, which are value-added activities, and which of them are not adding. Whatever are not adding, these are called as non-value-added activities. Okay. Now, in this particular case, whatever non-value-added activities are there, we try to think, let's slowly try to eliminate them from the system so as to save the cost. Okay. So, basically this entire process, first process, identify all the activities into these five categories. Okay. And then try to find out in each of the head, which are the value-added activities, which are the non-value-added activities. And we slowly try to say, let's only keep value-added activities that are contributing towards a profit. Let's try to eliminate non-value-added activities. That's what we are trying to say right now. So, the following are the benefits that accrue to WSS through a value chain analysis. Now see, value chain analysis is a process by which a firm identifies and analyzes various activities that add value to the product. That's what I said right now. The idea is to identify activities which do not add value to the final product or service. And thereafter eliminating such non-value added activities. Fine. The analysis of value chain can help a firm in obtaining cost leadership and improve product differentiation. Obviously, only through this, you will start to get your cost advantage and you will always start to improve further. Okay. You will try to have product differentiation. You will have some edge over your competitors. For WSS, value chain can provide more unambiguous picture of the value of the manufacturing function as perceived by the customers. Now, what does it mean? It means that through value chain, you will be coming to know that from customer's angle, which activity is required, which activity is not required. Like in our theory section, and also I guess when the practical lectures were going on. In this case, suppose at airport now, we don't do that stamping of the bags. That was a non-value added. From a customer's angle, from security angle, that those things do not add to anything. So therefore, such kind of non-value added activities have been stopped. They save a lot of cost for us. Second, the model also helps in analyzing other firms within the same industry. As WSS observed that other firms in the industry are considered to be more cost effective in terms of manufacturing, it may plan to use value chain model to examine the reason for the same. What these guys are saying, suppose your second process over here, second process, processing, okay. And then even this particular thing where installation part will be coming, okay. Now, what these guys are saying that through value chain, you will be able to find out that why are other firms having a lower cost as compared to you? Because everything is good about you, but your costs are very high. So there must be some activities that are increasing your cost. If those are non-value added, we would like to eliminate them further. The value chain will assist in WSS, will assist WSS to determine ways to get best approach towards developing higher competitive performance. This model assists firms in finding ways to develop higher level of performance either by cost leadership or product differentiation. Now, that is from where our theory section had started also. Two important things that every company should be doing: try to achieve cost leadership and try to achieve product differentiation. Honestly, this company already has product differentiation because whatever products they all make, okay, are exactly whatever the customer demands. And customers also agree that whatever solutions these guys provide are actually unmatched by the entire industry also. Right now, WSS is in a situation whereby it is being defeated on price by some of the competitors. However, is recognized as a best solution provider to the customer's problems. Through detailed value chain analysis, WSS may be able to ascertain the reason of falling down in such situation, and partners may be able to take the decision regarding future of the company. Now, example, in this case, what the company can be doing. Now, see, currently we have a manufacturing process and our installation. Over there, our costs are very high. So one of the things is try to do a detailed audit how manufacturing is happening. That is one thing. Second, in that, try to find out why is the cost becoming so high as compared to the competitors. Okay, I understand that we are leaders in terms of trying to give best solutions, but we are not leaders in terms of having lower cost. So try to find out where is your cost going up. There are two things. One is manufacturing, one is installation. Try to cut down all those particular costs. Now somebody can be saying, sir, how to cut down the cost? One way, try to do audit which of them are value added, non-value added. Okay, second, honestly, doing a breakup in form of value added and non-value added is not a very easy process, okay, but still try to do it to the extent you all can. But next thing that I'm trying to say is that in this case, you can also try to think that if we all cannot achieve economies, means savings, in manufacturing and in installation, we can also think of outsourcing that particular option. We can be doing it, right? Through the use of analysis, WSS may apply other relevant management techniques as well. Now this I will tell you. Example, your manufacturing process currently is not very good. Your costs are very high. You might try to think like, you know, we can start to apply business process re-engineering, BPR, okay, whereby we will change how we try to manufacture. But this will take a lot of time for sure. Cost will also be very high, but this is one of the techniques you all can do. Or you can outsource all these things to some other company who is a leader in that particular field. Post value chain, WSS will be in a position to decide whether it is worthwhile to continue technique of benchmarking against his rivals. Okay, what these guys are saying is that after value chain only, you'll be coming to know whether it is okay to compare our cost with that of the competitors, because their processes might be different, my processes might be different, so therefore it will become very difficult. Okay, so therefore if you think we should not compare, then you don't even compare also. Okay, but if you think it is worth comparing, then in that particular case, once you compare, you also try to find out the reasons why our cost is high and try to bring down that cost. To develop information system strategy to carry out a business process re-engineering or adopt activity-based cost management. That is whatever I told. Further, WSS may decide to outsource manufacturing and keep its focus on design and services by following value chain analysis model. Now see, this thing is very important for me. We will outsource the manufacturing and keep the focus on only designs and services where we were champions. Okay. See, you should always know good things about your business and some things that you are not good. If something you are not good, no, there are two options: either improve it or outsource it. That is the best thing. This technique may be appropriate for WSS, as by outsourcing the manufacturing, WSS may be able to focus on its core area on which it is well known in the industry. Obviously, you are a good solution provider. You understand what the customer wants. Keep your expertise over there. You are very good in after sales service, means the servicing contracts. Keep your focus over there. Let manufacturing go to somebody else. Value chain will also facilitate the development of performance metrics for WSS. means how we should try to judge you are doing good job or bad job. Example, in this case we can try to find out, say, cost per unit of each and every heater, and then try to compare it in this case with the industry. That could be one of the things, right? By developing such metrics, WSS may be able to identify which aspects of the models are not contributing to the overall value and profits of the firm. That is the basic need why value chain analysis has come. Although currently WSS has a suspicion that manufacturing and installation are weak parts of the operation, development of transparent and appropriate metrics would enable WSS to recognize where profit are being added in the business model. What these guys try to tell you, see, once you are going to be developing the KPIs, that how do we measure, okay, then use that particular thing to try to find out that which areas we all are lacking, where our cost and all is very high. Now, this is one thing. This is part first. Part second, discuss the criticisms or Porter's value chain analysis in reference to this company. Okay, honestly, many criticisms you all can try to say. The first one, number of criticisms that are there. First, this chain value chain analysis cannot be easily applied to the firms belonging to service industry. That's what I told you, it's mainly there for a manufacturing sector. Now, if you see basic structure of this company, it is a service company and it is a manufacturing company both. Okay, for such companies, no, it becomes very difficult, because value chain analysis, no, is a horizontal analysis. It says first inbound logistics will take place, then processing will take place, then outbound logistics will take place, then marketing and sales will happen, and then after sales service will be there. Now, honestly, it might be that many things over here are linked to many things. Try to think, no, the way you manufacture, in this case, that will also affect your services. That will also affect your sales. Sorry, that will also affect your sales. Because if your manufacturing is not very good, like in this particular question, your manufacturing is not very cost effective, so your cost is high. That affects your sales also. But all such kind of interlinking is not even considered. We have a lateral view like this. We don't try to connect all these particular things. Boss, it does happen that this is linked to this. No, yaar. It can happen, no, like that. In every company, your manufacturing is linked to your sales only. Example, Apple has a great manufacturing systems. Okay, therefore it can charge higher prices also. It can market its product also like that. But value chain analysis does not consider, it's just a horizontal view, like, you know, divide the company into this. But companies are not like this. The companies are networked. All these activities, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, these are connected to each other. This criticism is particularly imperative in the context of WSS, which has upward profit from rendering solutions and services rather than from manufacturing tangible products. So what these guys are saying, our main area from where we get the profit is actually, in this particular case, rendering solutions and services. Okay, how do we get major profit? First, we give the solutions, okay, and then we try to do after sales service. Okay, that is the main focus. So it's mainly a servicing company, okay, not actually a manufacturing company. Many people appreciate that model is more suitable for manufacturing based industries rather than based upon service industries. B, often this model is being seen as complicated and perhaps could be source of frustration by the management of the firm. Although staff of WSS includes bright and intelligent experts, they may not see value in-depth analysis of the business which is required for full value chain. Now, if you will ever go, no, in a company, you will find out this particular thing. Doing value chain is not a very easy job. You will not know when one activity ends and the other activity starts. It's not a very easy job to do. Example, raw material is coming in. Okay, I'm just giving you all example. Somebody can be saying, sir, it is inbound logistics. Perfect. Second, manufacturing is about to be starting. Okay, so that is nothing but the processing operation. In middle, there might be some activities. Example, inside your factory, raw material is moving from one place to another. Now, where do you classify such things? Okay. So it is a very difficult process, and honestly, no, those people who work in your company, okay, might be your experts also. See, those experts are good in providing solutions to the customers. They might not be very good in doing a value chain analysis, okay. Their technicalities, their expertise is basically there in what? We will provide good solutions to the customers. If you tell them, break the entire company into five different activities, those guys are least concerned about this, okay. So many times it is actually not a fruitful exercise. This analysis has a linear approach. Linear means horizontal approach, that's what I told you, and ignores the concept of value networks. As I told, we don't link this part with this particular part. We don't link this part with this particular part. It might happen that there are some things that are connected. Example, what do we say? That first this will happen, then this will happen, then this will happen, then this will happen, this will happen. You view all of them in an independent way. It is very difficult to view them in an independent way. Things are connected to each other. Example, quality of the raw material that you use over here, okay, might affect your after sales service. I'll give one example in reference to this, although not there as part of your answer, but see. Suppose a customer came, okay, he says that I want such kind of a thing, okay. Then we understand his needs and then we try to say, okay, we'll make it for you. Now the raw material comes. Now inbound logistics, how that raw material will be procured, that will affect the sales. Suppose for a small example, I try to think like this, that I tell my customer, see, I will have to be manufacturing this product based upon your needs. He says, okay, you give me a timeline. So then what did I do? I thought, like, you know, that whatever we are going to be manufacturing, for that this raw material will be required. That will take 2 months. Now that 2 months over there might result in me not getting sales also. It might happen that the customer will say, I cannot wait for 2 or 3 months, okay. You have raw material to get, that is your problem, but I want the geyser, say, in 3 days, okay. So your one thing will affect many other things, okay, but that is something that is not considered in such kind of a value chain analysis. This criticism is specifically relevant because its major business resorts to cooperative relationships that, you should read this, experts have with their customers. If WSS decides to outsource manufacturing and focus on design and service, this will become even more relevant where the relationships are more important. So that's what they are trying to say, like, you know, that our experts, our manufacturing guys will have the relationship, okay, with the experts. Now all such kind of networks are not even considered over here. D, often value chain is perceived as time consuming and expensive process. However, if the analysis is to be completed timely, there will be requirement of reliable data such as cost of the components in the business model. However, in absence of a good cost capturing system, this model could prove to be very costly process. After the completion of the process, there is still no guarantee that the process will lead to upward trend in profitability. What these guys are saying, see, many people know, always try to think that, and honestly, I might be saying this thing off record, but even I am also one person who starts to think that you should not do too much analysis of the things, okay. It entails cost. Get on with the business. Whatever you think are your plus points, try to see those particular plus points. If something is a weak point, try to outsource. Value chain sometimes becomes too expensive. It'll take too much amount of time. And even after doing such kind of segmentation, no, there is honestly no guarantee. See, some activities somebody can be saying is value added, somebody can be saying non-value added. It takes lot of effort to arrive at a certain conclusion, okay. So these things are debatable. You might not arrive at a conclusion. The last thing. Now the last part over here was what? Part third. Explain any other form of value chain analysis that might be more suitable for WSS. Now WSS originally, if you'll try to see, they do manufacturing also, they do service also. Now where do you get their major profits from? Sir, we get major profits from the service. We provide the solutions. Perfect. Now once we all do that particular thing, then In that case, once we do this kind of analysis, that value added, non-value added, okay, we are a service and a manufacturing company, but after doing the analysis, we realize manufacturing and installation is not our strength. So therefore, if you decide to outsource that particular thing to some other company, you manufacture and install the things for us, we will give you what to manufacture. Okay. Try to think, then you will only remain as a service provider. If you are only going to remain as a service provider, then in that particular case, actually Porter's value chain analysis will not apply to you. Then you should shift to value shop analysis. That is far, far, far better. That is basically made for a company who is there in the service sector. Now, secondary activities under value chain and value shop are same only, but primary activities differ because we are a solution provider to your problems. So, if suppose you all have a problem, I'll try to come up with an idea. I will try to have various options. I will execute some options and I will monitor that whatever options I've given to you, whatever we are implementing now, is it working or not? If it is not working, we'll have some other ideas. That is the concept of value shop. Now, WSS requires to acknowledge that the nature of the business is turning from, read this, manufacturing zone to a solution provider. From this point of view, it will be better for WSS to analyze its business using professional value services or value shop model. The concept came into limelight holding the hand of Charles B. Stable and Austin D. Fizat in 1998. This concept aims to service firms from serve the firms from the service sector. It only deals with the problems, figure out the main area requiring services, and finally come out with a solution. This approach is designed to solve customers' problems rather than creating value by producing output from an input raw material. So basically, this kind of a model is applicable for any company that provides solutions. And best example of all such companies are basically IT companies. Example, 2 years ago when I required an ERP system for my institute, obviously at that time I approach a technical guy, okay, they come and they study our business and then they try to think what kind of a ERP system will be best for them. A value shop mobilizes resources, say people, knowledge or money, to solve specific problems such as delivering a solution to a business problem. This shop model is iterative, involving repetitive performing a generic set of activities until a solution is reached. Further, secondary activities in professional value chain have same support activities as in Porter's team. That's what I told. However, the primary activities are described differently to recognize different nature of service-oriented business. In value shop, those are. Now, these are the primary activities, but under value shop model. First, problem finding and acquisition. Example, this kind of a company. It finds out the problems that the customers are facing. Okay. Second, it gives them a solution for that. Third, now giving the solution, it might have, say, two or three options. How you would like to go about the things. There might be two or three ways, right? Execution and control and re-evaluation. Then whatever out of the few ways that we have selected over here, whatever way we all have selected, implement that. But once you implement, do not leave it. Okay. Example, I'll tell you. Suppose I'm a management consultant. Okay. Now suddenly in this case, I find that one day one company approached me and they told, sir, workers in our company are leaving too often, sir. What is the problem? Okay. I told them that I will study your business. Okay. And then in that particular case, I will try to tell you what is the best option. So try to think, I am a solution provider to your problem. I am a management accountant. I am a management consultant. Okay. So basically my job is what? To give the solution to your problems. Now, when you come out with such kind of a problem, you try to think value chain analysis will be of no use here. What is the use? There is no inbound logistics. There is no manufacturing. Now, this is a problem that we all are facing. So, what to do? First of all, I recognize their problems. workers are leaving too often. Okay. I try to think, why are they leaving too often? Are they not paid well? Are they not treated well? So I want to solve the problem. I want that workers do not leave. Okay. Then choosing among solutions, I try to think, what can be done? Can we increase their wages? Okay. Can we transform them, say, from temporary workers to permanent workers so that they all have job securities? Okay. So whatever are the alternates, you consider those alternates and trying to implement. I thought, let's not implement both of them. Let's implement the first one. Let's increase their wages. So therefore, I executed. But now you have to control and do evaluation. Example, once we implemented, say that after 3 months, we still realize that workers are leaving only. Okay. Then in that case, try to think, will other solution work? If we convert them from temporary workers to permanent workers, will they still go? So this is a continuous process. Okay. In such cases, value chain analysis might not be of use. So value shop analysis will be of bigger use. So for companies which are basically solution provider, try to have a value shop system. The management in a value shop focuses on areas like problem solving and opportunity assessment, resource mobilization, project management, solution delivery, outcome measurement and learning. So those companies who are mainly dealing in all these particular things, for them, value shop is far better than value chain. Okay. This was your case study number one. Your next case study will be completely on a value chain analysis. Okay. But this one was just an introduction and a demarcation to which company's value chain applies, to which company's value shop applies. That was your case study number one.